Delacroix, a long time ago, the guy said Degas, and Delacroix was actually the artist that painted Chopin and George Sand. And then the guy talked to you about Saint-Saëns, he said the guy wrote three symphonies, he wrote five. Okay, three of them were numbered. And, of course, this last video that he played, he didn't even have the courtesy to tell you what you were listening to. Well, it's more Tchaikovsky. It's a ballet suite from his late ballet. He did a couple of ballets, The Nutcracker. And now the dance suite tradition pretty much is now the ballet suite. It tends to be condensations, greatest hits from full-scale ballets. And in this case, you heard four dances that really, in the grand opera, grand ballet tradition, do not advance the story much at all. But we get some wonderful instances of exoticism through here, and also early use of the bell keyboard, the celesta. So you had the dance of the sugar plum fairy, followed by, well, it was a kind of racist, at least in the Disney depiction here. And is Disney once again going to let me put it on? Find out as soon as this attempts to be downloaded, the video that is, Chinese dance, where the main theme isn't even pentatonic, but the counter theme is bum 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 bum, followed by the Arabian dance. Again, go figure that Disney sets the Arabian dance underwater, but wonderful da 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 da, synthetic Eastern kind of macomb-like scale going on. And then finally a Russian dance. So at least, you know, if he's evoking magic from different cultures, he's also dealing with his own. So that would be an example of nationalism. All right, Tchaikovsky, better finish this up. Interesting person, and at one point he gets married and flees the marriage bed, it was said, on the wedding night. The marriage does last a couple months. Has another long-term relationship with a woman, but it's Madame von Meck, who he never meets, or at least maybe only sees once at a distance. And the deal is she's going to be his patron, but only if I never meet you. That's from von Meck's. Indeed, he was much more attracted to members of his own sex. The Russian government tried to cover this up after his death. It was sort of known, not known, but I tell you, it must have been known towards the end, because evidently there was a dalliance with, this is at least a rumor, with one of the Tsar's relatives, and there's been recent research that seems to suggest that Tchaikovsky's own musical colleagues advised him to kill himself. Unbelievable. This last symphony of six, the Pathetique, and the Beethoven tradition, that is pathos, strong emotion rather than pathetic. We're focusing on the first movement, a sonata allegro, has a very stern introduction. It was premiered 6 days before his death, da-da-da-da, in the bassoon, and then transformed for the first theme, is da-da-da-da. Then we'll cut to the very end of the second theme. It's very languorous, and the relationships between first themes and second themes in the Romantic era can be a little abstruse, although in some ways it's kind of a balance. The second theme, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, goes down when the first theme went up. Mozart would be proud. And indeed, there's that indeed again. That other guy uses it far too much, in my opinion. But that's a kind of balance that Mozart would have appreciated. And indeed, I said it again, Tchaikovsky appreciated the music of Mozart. And it was, in many ways, more the conservative classicist amongst these Russian composers, but not as much as the dyed-in-the-wool conservatives. Anyway, a bit of Haydn-esque development, as you'll hear, a surprise symphony motive. And then we're going to cut to the chase of just a bit of a through line the rest of the symphony. Second movement, since the first movement's not that fast in some ways, the second movement is the dance. And what a dance! It's in 5-4. Mussorgsky would be proud. This is the first consistent 5-4 with which I'm familiar, and so Holst would take off his hat for in thanks for doing that then much later in The Planets. And Russian folk music does use asymmetrical rhythm that tend to have modular form, kind of slice and dice. This will impact later Russian composers too, notably in early Stravinsky. Third movement, we're still pretty rapido because, again, the second movement is, it's moderate, it moves, but the third movement is actually the fastest movement of all, and it is a march, and an evolutionary march, somewhat in the traditional form, but somewhat not. We'll just hear the finale of that. And then the actual finale to the symphony is finally the slow movement. I guess when you're 6 days away from dying, when this is premiered, you can't be too happy. Did it get much applause? The main melody at the very beginning, da 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 da, kind of related to the second theme of the first movement. But this, like Alet Salete Cum Luia and several other pieces we've heard, no one actually plays that descending line. Instead, it's da, 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 different strings. Oh, yeah, it was Beethoven that also did that. All right, here we go.